Hi, my name is Gustavo Silveira,
and this is the XT Synth. So I'm about to do this video since forever. I made the XT Synth in the beginning of 2018, but I never had the chance of actually making a video explaining what it is and how it works. So that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to introduce you, I think, my most beautiful creation, the XT Synth. So first, what is this guy here? You must be thinking, it's a synthesizer, of course, because it's called XT Synth. The truth is that it's a MIDI controller. And why I call it a synthesizer and XT Synth? Because first, the first idea was making it a synthesizer. Actually, the project started as it being a synthesizer, and then I added the MIDI controller capabilities, and then I just got rid of the synth because of many reasons. It was kind of too complicated, was expensive, and it was taking too much time, while with MIDI I could do something so flexible and way easier and cheaper than a synthesizer that I just decided I'm going like full-blown MIDI controller and getting rid of the synth part. So I may just change its name for XT Controller. So let's talk a little bit about the idea behind the instrument. If you don't know, I am a multi-instrumentalist. I play the guitar, but I also play a little bit of the violin, I play the flute, and I play the keyboard. I love synthesizers, I love MIDI controllers. And I always wanted to have something that was a mix of the different instruments that I play and with a mix of the sounds that I like. So in 2018, while I was still doing my master's in music technology at Georgia Southern University, I saw a deadline for the Goodman Musical Instrument Competition, which is one of the biggest competitions for new musical instruments in the world. I had 2 weeks to develop an instrument. At that time I thought, that's the perfect excuse for me to develop that old idea of getting a little bit of a guitar with a little bit of a violin with a little bit of a synthesizer and a lot of a MIDI controller. Of course, 2 weeks was a crazy deadline, but I went for it and I was able to build the first prototype. I worked for 2 weeks like crazy until I got like one thing working, and I made like in the last minute I was able to finish a video and send to the competition. Against all the odds, I was accepted to the competition. But of course, I made the instrument in 2 weeks. That was not good enough for winning a competition. So I decided to myself that I would do a second prototype, and then I had 3 months to finish. In 3 months, I built the second prototype, which is this guy here, which is still a prototype, is not perfect, has several flaws that I'm going to talk about, but it's still way better than the first. So long story short, I went to Georgia Tech for the competition, I got to the finals, I didn't win, but it still was a great experience.
This is Gustavo Silvada.
So let's talk about the instrument. So the XT Synth is a MIDI controller, which is totally plug and play, that can work with any digital synthesizer. So let's talk a little bit about how you play this instrument. In a sense, it's similar to a guitar in its left hand technique. So here in the neck, I have four sensors, which are actually soft potentiometers that track the position of my finger in the X axis. So if I press a string, I can get a MIDI note. The thing is that instead of working as a keyboard where you have discrete notes or like just C, C sharp, D, D sharp, you can actually do microtonal things. Just like a fretless instrument. The thing is, it's fretless-ish. It's a mix of a fretted with a fretless instrument. But how come? Note if I just press without sliding. You can hear the chromatic scale, like I had frets, right? But once I press, you don't hear the frets anymore. So one of the coolest things about the XT Synth is the system that I developed that once you press the first time, it quantizes to the next fret, which makes it perfectly in tune. So it's way easier to play in tune than a violin, for example. But once you press, now you are free to do the slides up and down. Right? Another thing is that it's polyphonic. You can play all the strings at the same time and do different pitch bends for each way. So, for example, which means that it has MIDI polyphonic expression, which is the same feature that you can find in the Rolly Seaboard, for example. It allows different expressions in different notes, so you can have different pitch bends for each note. So now let's talk about how I use my right hand. So far I was just using the left hand, so it can be used in different ways, but let's see how I do it. So you can see that I have this sort of, it's a potentiometer, but I play like I was playing like a pick in the guitar. However, I do the articulations like I was using a bow of a violin. So all those things here in my right hand, they are totally MIDI assignable. So you can assign any of those things to any parameter. So for example, if you see here in my synth, I have this potentiometer here mapped to the frequency of a filter. So I think that for me, it's the way that I just found like idiomatic for this instrument. I control the envelope with my right hand like I was playing the bow, but in a way that's familiar for a guitar player because my main instrument is the guitar. So as I showed you, I have this potentiometer, I also have this rotary potentiometer, and I have rotary encoders. and also I have pressure sensors. And each of them can be mapped to anything in your jaw or in your synth. So let's talk a little bit about the rotary encoders. I have four rotary encoders that if you move them, you can see, it's a little bit hard to see in the video, but they go from red to blue. I chose this type of encoder because you can have this LED feedback, so you can know when you go from minimum to maximum. Also, those encoders, they are push buttons. And I mapped them to different things. So for example, so first I have these two here that I can control the octave, and then this other two here, I can change the MIDI channel of the strings. This way I can play different sounds every time I change the bank, for example. And another thing, I can have one different instrument for each string, since each string is in a different MIDI channel. And another nice thing about the encoders is that, you know that MIDI ranges from 0 to 127. Sometimes it's hard to just tell by the colors, so I have a display here. So if I turn my knobs here, you can see that it changes from the 0 to 127. And you can also see which octave you are and in which bank you are. And also, when you change the bank, the value of each encoder is restored. So you can change the banks, and the last value that was stored here is just going to come back. Now there's the pressure sensors. Unfortunately, in my poor design, the pressure sensors were not really well placed, and they all broke in the chips that I've made with it. So I won't be able to show you today. But basically, they're just pressure sensors that send MIDI CC. So you can control four things at the same time with four different fingers. There's also a key here that changes the mode of the pressure sensors, where you can use them to actually pluck the strings. But you just have to believe me and picture in your mind. And of course, it looks kinda crazy. It's inspired in sacred geometry, and this sacred geometry here specifically is two hexagons, which you have 12 corners, and if you think about music, 12 notes, but also you have all those lines that connect to the notes, which means that you have like all the microtones between each note. And of course, lots of LEDs, so I can communicate with the aliens. And the way it's built is this part here. It's a sheet of acrylic, and those crazy trails are made with acrylic engraving. And that's how I have this effect, when you have LED lights pointing inside the acrylic, when you have the engraving, they shine like they were like L wires or something. And the body is 3D printed. You can see that's divided in a couple pieces. That doesn't look as good as in the front, but it's just for you to see that's really a prototype and there's so much more to be done. So the XT Synth is not for sale yet, but you can subscribe to the list and get the notifications when it's released. Or you can learn how to make your own MIDI controllers with my free course, the DIY MIDI Controller Workshop, where I teach you the basics. Or my super duper ultra mega making music with Arduino, where I teach all the building blocks to make something like the XT Synth. Rotary encoders, potentiometers, everything, LED lights, you name it. So So if you like this video, please give a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do yet. And ring the bell to get notifications about my next videos. And please let me know what you think about this instrument. Do you have any advice, anything that you'd like me to do, or any idea or partnership? Do you want to help me to get this project done in the near future? I need help. I really need. So guys, playing this instrument is lots of fun. So I hope you had a little fun too. See you next.